to Yogi's. We'll be moving a little slower today. It's typical that in vinyasa practice, it can get quite fast. And what we need sometimes is to slow down. So like anything in life, there are dualities on your mat too. We need to be both soft and strong. So today we're going to uncover some of the soft. We'll set a mantra for our practice today. You are right on time. I think I need that constant reminder that I am right on time. You are right on time. You are right where you're meant to be. So any variation of that mantra, it could even be as simple as I am home. You are right on time. We're using a playlist on Spotify. It's called Flexibility and Shavasana. It's right at the top. It's linked in the comments if you need it. And we'll start seated, finding our breath. If it feels good to you, I invite you to close your eyes. If it's wicked uncomfortable, keep them open. Maybe gaze down. Start to really deepen our breath and hone in on where it's starting, where it's entering the body is your nose. Take a deep breath in through your nose. The breath moves down to the base of your belly. Once it hits there, your belly expands like a balloon. Exhale through the nose. Let's try that again, but this time we'll move the breath down, up. Inhale through your nose, filling up your belly, your ribs and your collarbone. Exhale, release, follow that wave of breath from collarbone to base of belly, and then I want us to give an extra push out at the base of the belly to give stagnant air, stuck energy, anything that's not serving you today. Again, deep breath in, using that mantra as a mind tool. You are right on time. Exhale through the nose. Flick your eyes open. Meet me in child's pose. Big toes touching, take your knees pretty wide. Walk your hands out in front of you, forehead down, chin to chest. One more time, we're breathing into the back sides of the rib cage. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Let's walk our hands all the way to the right. Take your right ear to your bicep of your right arm. Hold. We're looking for an extension of the lateral side of the body, the left side. You can stack your palms. Maybe off-centering your hips to the left, getting a little bit more leverage as we reach right. Beautiful, let's come back to center. And then we'll take both of your hands over to the left. Stack your palms, left ear down. Come back to center. Push into box. Check in with your mantra, that mind tool. You are right on time. You are right where you need to be. Let's take some cat-cows. Inhale, open. Drop your belly. Look up. Open your heart. On your next exhale, tuck the chin. Tuck the pelvis. Find your cat. So we're rounding with from the cervical spine, thoracic spine, tucking the lumbar, navel to spine is our gaze. Beautiful. Let's take that in a little one breath, one movement. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Cat. One more time. Bringing mindful movement into the body. Exhale, contract. Cat is really important. One more time, breathe in.
And breathe out. You are activating your parasympathetic nervous system. Breath and movement. Breathe in. And breathe out. You'll sleep better. You'll live better. One more time. Breathe in. You'll probably have better posture and better relationships. Exhale. Cat. Beautiful. Come to neutral neck, neutral spine. We'll take the left leg behind us. And then plant the foot on the floor. Right hand stays down. Inhale. Open up to modified side plank. So that right foot, it's glued to your mat. And your wrists are in one line. And you can keep your feet in like a tightrope, so knee is aligned with your ankle, or you can open it up if you need a little bit more of a kickstand. This is just a balance issue. Same posture, same shape. All right, pull in your belly and we'll lift this up, moving into gate pose. Teeing out our arms, take a deep breath in through your nose. Exhale, shoulders come down. So you're finding that beautiful alignment. On your next inhale, flip your right palm, reach up and over for gate. A lot of times we get into these shapes and we feel things stretching that we didn't even know needed to be stretched. And it doesn't matter how long you've been practicing yoga, you'll always feel it. That's what keeps it coming back. So from hip point all the way out, the lateral side of the body to the middle fingertip, you're feeling this line of energy moving out and up. Beautiful. Let's take one more reach, inhale. And then on your exhale, we'll spiral ourselves all the way down back to box pose. Extend the right leg behind you. And then stamp the foot. So either in that tight rope or you can kickstand the leg. We move into modified side plank. Stack your wrists, stack your joints. You can look up. Know that sometimes that doesn't serve our necks. So go to a space that feels good for you. Pull your belly in. Hop to your fingertips as we rise up. Tee out your arms, take an inhale, exhale, breathe in. Breathe out. Flip your front palm. Gate pose. Beautiful. One more big inhale as we reach, and then exhale, we come back to box pose. All right, curl into your toes. Slowly roll back into downward facing dog. So you're in inverted V shape, and it doesn't have to be anything fancy. Your knees can be completely bent. I encourage you to bend your knees. If you see yourself rolling the head up, we don't want to, that's no bueno, we don't want the head up. If you find yourself, your wrists are uncomfortable, I invite you to put a wedge under your mat. You can even roll your mat up a little bit to give yourself like a little wedge where your wrists are higher than your fingertips. So it'll look like this. And your knees, always, always, they can be bent. Hips are the highest thing we want in our down dog. All right, you can pedal out your feet here. Just sit with any sensations that are starting to bubble up. Beautiful. And we'll slowly start to walk our hands to our feet. And you can put a generous bend in your knee. This is the first time around for a forward fold. Connect opposite elbows. Release the weight of your head from your neck. Our heads get super heavy. Connecting opposite elbows, maybe you start to ragdoll rock from side to side. Beautiful. Let's plant our hands. Drop to your knees. Take your feet, I'll face you. Take your feet wider than your knees and then sit your hips down in between your feet. This is called Hero's Pose. This pose symbolizes your strength. I want us to check in with our mantra at this time in our practice.
You are right on time. And just take a couple of deep breaths here. Inhale that mind tool, bring it into your awareness, and then exhale anything that doesn't believe it. It's important here. Okay, ready? Inhale. Trust the timing of my life. I'm right on time, whatever you chose. Exhale anything that says otherwise. Beautiful. And hero's pose is a great stretch if you have healthy knees for ankles, for the arches of the feet, and for the quad, of course. Inhale, arms up. On your exhale, we'll take a side drift to the right. Beautiful. Inhale, come back up to center. And exhale over to the left. Let's come back to center. Push into your hands. Take your feet together. And we'll roll back into downward facing dog. Step the right foot in between the hands. Back knee down, top of the foot down. Both of your hands can come to the inside of your right foot, or you can stay in this runner stretch, keep pretty lifted here. Either way, we'll be here for about 5 breaths. This is coming pretty easy to you. Drop your forearms to the earth. Beautiful. Let's take both of our hands, straddle your front foot, and we'll pull our hips back, but keep the right leg pretty straight. You can flex the foot, point the foot, it doesn't matter. If it's too much to stay lifted, you could always walk the hands back and sit, so you're sitting on your left heel, your left foot. Half split is a really cool pose to experience, because you're getting out of the joints. So if you were to attempt a full split, this would just give it a little bit more accessibility to you. And same posture, right? It's still a split, but it's a half split. We'll take some big deep breaths here. Breathe in. Breathe out. Available to you. You can take your nose to your knee or your chin to your shin. Know that there's always places to go within the shape once you get there. Beautiful. Let's take our hands down. Start to walk your hands to the front of the mat. Frame your right foot. Hop up onto the ball of your left toes. And then your right arm will go up. This is dragonfly twist. Your knee can also stay down if you need less. If you need more, charge up the left leg. Beautiful, big breath in. And on your out breath, take both of your hands down, downward facing dog. I want you to inquire about the opening of the right side of the body compared to the left. You have done about 3 hip opening poses on the right, and just notice what 3 poses can do to the tendons, the ligaments, the fascia. And then step your left foot in between your hands. Back knee down. Top of the back foot down for runner stretch. Make your breath fluid. Celebration of your life. Weaving in your mantra whenever you spin off. And when you do spin off, and you will, it's not easy to sit in these poses for minutes at a time. But know that when you spin off, you do not have to go with the thought. Bring it back to your breath. Back to your mantra, you're right on time. Coming down to your forearms if it serves you today. let's take both hands on either side of the left foot. We'll shift the weight of the hips back. Half split. This is Ardha Hanumasana. Half is Ardha. Hanuman is monkey pose. So you're in half monkey pose. For me today, this just isn't feeling good. So I'm going to sit my hips back to my heel.
Nose to knee, chin to shin if you want.
Beautiful. And we'll sit with this for a bit. Beautiful. Let's look up. Start to walk your hands to either side of your left foot, framing the foot. Curl under the right toes. Right hand down, left arm up for dragonfly twist. And again, on the toes or on the knee for an option to make it a gentler day. You can turn your gaze up or leave it neutral. Take it one last downward facing dog. Beautiful. From here, inhale, bend the knees, look forward. Exhale, walk or float. You're at the top of your mat. And we'll come to seated. The next few postures will be held for about 2 minutes each. I know it's a lot, but there is a reason to the holds. So to get into the deep tissue of a yin posture, you have to break down the first barrier, which is that clinging sensation. So when I'm in a half pigeon, I'm probably clinging like musculature-wise for the first 20 seconds until I can really find some deep belly breathing to release. So make your way into half pigeon, and instead of talking about it, let's do it. So your right knee comes to the right corner of your mat. Left knee down, top of your left foot down. Okay. This pose intensifies as the heel comes away from the body. If you need more, heel away. If you need less, heel comes in. Take a deep breath in. On your exhale, start to walk your hands down. Put your forearms down. Maybe your chest comes down, your shoulders come down. And already you can feel the clinging along the right side hip, right? All along the glute, all along the hamstring, the IT band, everything's kind of clenched. Okay, so now it's time for you to draw upon your breath. Take a deep breath in through your nose, filling up your belly, your ribs, your chest. On your exhale, I want you to see if you can let go as much muscular engagement as you can on the left side of the body. Beautiful. Another time we're going to do it. Inhale through the nose, filling up your belly, ribs, chest. I want you to let go of any muscular engagement along the right side of the body, including the side that we're pushing right now, the right glute, the right calf, the right hamstring, the right quad, hip point, low back. I want you to keep doing that as we move through this pose for about 2 minutes. Pressure over time in these yin poses creates change in the body. So with every inhale, you're preparing for some sort of opening. And on every exhale, you're finding that space to sink, to soften, to melt. And over time, you'll find some softness and you'll be able to really melt into this pose. Chest down, belly down. We have about 30 more seconds here.
And if that comes up, you do not have to go with it. Beautiful. Let's take a deep breath in and you take your hands to your mat. Slowly, we'll start to rock to the left and then take our right knee back, moving into box pose. Want us to find some mobility along the right side of the body and the hip by rolling out the ball and socket joint. Switch directions. Beautiful. And you can take some big hip circles here if you like. Coming in neutral neck, neutral spine. Take the left leg in front of us. Back knee down, top of the back foot down. Breathe in. Breathe out in full. 2 minutes. I'm going to give you the space here to explore silence. Deep breaths, my friends. Deep breaths. We're about a minute down in our half pigeon. Deepen your breath. Release as much engagement along the left side body as you can. Up, pop up onto your hands, rock your body to the left just a bit to wiggle that left foot under you. We're in box pose. Beautiful. And from here, cross your ankles behind you. Let's wiggle our feet all the way through and come all the way down to our backs. Bring your knees into your chest, give yourself a big hug. Beautiful. Extend both legs to the sky. Catch the left leg, extend the right. Nose to knee or chin to shin. You can lift up through your shoulders, or you can take a more gentle head to knee pose with your shoulders and your spine and the back of your head on the mat. Beautiful. Bend your left knee. Let's take it over to the right. Gaze left. Beautiful. Come back to center. We'll take both the knees into the chest. Extend your right leg, left leg forward. Bend your right knee. Breathe in. And on your exhale, take it to the left. Look right.
center.
Let's end in Baddha Konasana. So this is Supta Baddha Konasana. Supta means supine. Your feet are together, your heels are together, your hips are open, knees wide. So it's like a reclined butterfly pose. If you have a stack of books and your hips are just like screaming at you right now, you can take books underneath your femur bone and prop yourself up a bit. Let's take 10 deep breaths here. More deep belly breaths. In for five. Out for five. Last two. Take your hands to the outsides of your legs. Pull your legs together. Go slow. Now we'll extend our legs out for Shavasana. I'm going to exit this pose, but I'll wake you up in about 5 minutes. Nowhere to go, nothing to do, and I want you to enjoy it fully. If you lost track of your mantra, bring it back now. Trust the timing of your life. And nowhere to go, nothing to do. Breathe.
taking a deep breath in through the nose, filling up your belly, your ribs, your chest. Maybe it's time now to open up your mouth and sigh it out. Since you're in the comfort of your own home, you can get pretty loud here. Again, deep breath in. And sigh it out. Wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, reach your arms back, feet towards the front of your room. Give yourself a big hug and then mantra time. Check back in. Trust the timing of your life. You are right on time. I am home. Whatever it was for you, leave it. Go write it down when you leave your mat today. See if it can serve you later on off the mat. When maybe you get a little bit worried or anxious or fearful or something bubbles up that doesn't sit well with you, check in and check in often. It will help, I promise. Come to easy sit or Sukhasana, hands at your side body. And we'll gather up all this beautiful energy today. I invite you to take it with you, hands, feet, and high prayer at the top. On a slow exhale, they find your heart. And from my heart directly to yours, all my love, all my blessings, and all my light. Namaste.